Pierre Laneuville. I'm a hematologist at the McGill University Health Center in Montreal, and I'm here attending the EHA meeting in Madrid. And I'd like to share with you a poster that was by Dubeck and colleagues that I think has some bearing on how to choose an agent for elderly patients in first line with CLL. And as you know, in Canada, we have choice variety of regimens. We have chemotherapy, FCR, we have bendamustine monotherapy in combination with Taxan. We have clonbucil with and without obinutuzumab. And of course, more recently, we have ibrutinib that's been approved not only for patients with P53 abnormalities, but also generally for all patients in principle in first line. So question is always how to choose. Certainly we have impartial data comparing all these different agents. We have the CLL10 study. It shows that FCR is the most efficacious in terms of progression-free survival. But bendamustine rituximab is very close and with much less toxicity, particularly in older patients above age 65. We also, of course, have trial data between clonbucil with and without obinutuzumab, and the combination being more powerful. And also we had results from the RESONATE-2 study that was shown at previous meetings. And in that study, there's ibrutinib was randomized against clorambucil 0.5 milligrams per kilogram on a bi-weekly basis. And you may recognize that unfortunately we don't have really comparative data. So this poster by Dubeck was very useful in that what they took is the data from the progression-free survival and overall survival from the ibrutinib arm of RESONATE-2. And they compared that to two databases, one a Czech database called CLEAR, and the other one from France, a so-called Lyon-Sud database, and combined, looked at 510 patients that had been selected in the same way that patient had been selected RESONATE-2, that is, they're above age 65, and they did not have the excluded patients at P53 abnormalities. So the bottom line is, when they compared all the treatments that patients had received in those two databases, the overall progression-free survival was 4.1-fold higher in the ibrutinib patients compared to all the other therapies collectively, and the overall survival is over threefold higher as well. And that carried through your individual regimens. For example, progression-free survival for FCR, BR, and clonbucil rituximab, for example, had a 3.7-fold advantage in favor of ibrutinib. Similarly, if one looked at the overall survival, there was a also an overall survival for FCR, BR, and our clonbucil in favor of ibrutinib, which ranged from 2.3 for FCR all the way to 3.7-fold for clonbucil and rituximab. So although this is not randomized data, it's pretty extensive and well-balanced comparison of the different regimens available in Canada. And it really makes a strong point that ibrutinib gives a superior, or is likely to give superior, progression-free survival and overall survival compared to the other therapies that are available for older patients that are P53 negative.